lost you. Thanks for stopping by my channel. My name is Shiloh and I am a cross stitcher and knitter living in Nova Scotia, Canada. You can find me on Instagram as at xstitchmd and on Ravelry as at Dr. Shiloh. I'll have a link in the description box below with all the projects I'm working on in case you feel enabled and want to work on them as well. So it's been 3 weeks since my last video. I was working the past 2 weekends, which led to no video being recorded, but I am back on schedule-ish with recording today. That does also mean that I have a lot more progress to share since it's been 3 weeks instead of two. To start off with, I'll just say that the winners for last video's giveaway from Fabric Flare, I drew the winners for that and I have contacted them on Instagram. I believe the winner of the pink fabric was Sandra and the winner of the red fabric, I'm drawing a blank on, but they have both been messaged on Instagram. So make sure to check your messages. And if you are the winner, just let me know your mailing address so I can mail that fabric out to you. Thanks so much for all your comments on my last video. It's really fun to read them and I love reading all the creative ways that people include the giveaway words in. So that was really fun. I do have another giveaway today, which I will talk about a little bit later. But first of all, let's show my stitching progress. So over the past 3 weeks, I got motivated to pull out a bunch of my older whips that have just been languishing pretty much for the past year. And I pulled out a couple of them and gave them a bit of attention, which has been really fun. So let's show you what I've been working on. This project is one that I started as a stitch along with Megan, Georgia Girl Stitching. And we are calling this one the hashtag Cuz Quaker Sal because we love Quakers. So this is the Patchwork Garden Quaker from Wienberg Designs. And I got this as a PDF download from their website. It comes in a couple different colors. The colorway I chose and that Megan's doing as well is called the Monet's Garden. And here is where I am on this. So I got quite a bit of a few more motifs done and the fabric color is actually showing up really nice here. It's quite hard to take a picture of. The fabric color is aqua and it's a 36 count Edinburgh linen from Swigert. Really beautiful. I'm using all the called for colors and I think it's so fun, all the little motifs, like there's a little fly there and a swan. And yeah, it's really, really pretty. I also really like how the motifs are all kind of interspersed on top of each other, which is really fun. And yeah, it's just a really, really fun design. So I'm really enjoying working on this. So that is my Patchwork Quaker, and that will definitely be getting more attention the rest of this summer because it would be so nice to have it framed and up on my wall. The next one I worked on is also a stitch along with Georgia Girl Stitcher. I don't think it's an official stitch along, but we were both working on it. And this is called Beachcomber by Carolyn Manning Design. And she has a whole series of these patterns called the Shooting Star series. And they're in all different colors and they're all beautiful. And I kind of need them all, which you might need them at all as well. I also got this as a PDF download from her website and I think it was only like $6 US, so it's very reasonably priced. So here's where I'm at with this. And it is just so pretty. So those of you who have watched me for a while know that I am not a fan of 40 count, but I'm stitching this on 40 count and I actually am not hating it, which is high praise. So I'm using 40 count Mallow by Swigert, which is kind of like hard to describe. It's almost like a fiddler's Aida, but it's an even weave, or maybe it's a linen. I'm not really sure if it's an even weave or a linen, but it's kind of like a rustic-y fabric. And it looks like the holes would be hard to see, but they actually aren't. And I find it quite enjoyable to stitch. The thing though, is that I really don't like using one strand. And so I'm stitching this with one strand of floss on 40 count. And I find that I must just pull my thread too hard, but I break my thread a lot when I use 40 count. And I know I'm probably using too long of strands, but I like using long strands. And I also am I'm using a small size needle, so I feel like it's not that my needle, the eye of the needle is wearing or anything. I think it's just that I pull my thread very tightly, which yes, maybe I do that, but regardless, that's what really slows me down with projects like these. But the colors in this are just so pretty that I'm really enjoying working on it. Another great thing is I discovered that this I was able to load this pattern into Pattern Keeper, which has just made stitching it so much more enjoyable. Because this is a full coverage design, having it in Pattern Keeper just makes it so much easier to see like where I'm going next and what colors are beside each other. So highly recommend that if you do have the Pattern Keeper app. It's an Android only app, but there's a lot of really cheap tablets that you can buy that it'll work on. And I have linked in the description box below the tablet that I use, and I think I paid like $90 or something for it on Amazon. So a little plug for that. Okay, the next old whip that I pulled out was the Twisted Rainbow Sampler by Vivian Powers. And this pattern was recently re-released on the Silk Stitching app. And so I had already bought this like last year from Vivian Powers' Etsy shop as PDF, really enjoying working on it. I had set it aside because that's what I do. And then I saw that it was re-released on the Silk app. So I actually repurchased it on the Silk app because I love using the Silk app. So I had an interesting discussion on Instagram over the past week about the differences between like the Silk app and Pattern Keeper, and they are quite different. So I'll just like run through that really quick for you. The main two big differences. One is that Pattern Keeper is Android only and Silk is iOS only or Apple only. The other big difference is that Pattern Keeper, you can load in patterns. So most PDF patterns will load into it. Some of them will not. For example, the Patchwork Quaker from Weinberg does not work in there, and it has to do with the file type it's saved as, and that's something on the designer's end. So as far as I know, it's not something you can convert to make it Pattern Keeper compatible, but if I'm wrong, please let me know. So for Pattern Keeper, you can upload patterns into the app. Silk, you can't upload patterns into the app, but they sell patterns directly in their app. Pattern Keeper does not sell patterns. So Silk has patterns available in their pattern store, which you purchase and then you know they automatically work there. And they have quite a few different designers. So they have their own designers. So Silk was started by Dorothy from Historic Steak Mooster. So her patterns, a lot of her patterns are there. They also just have added in Vivian Powers. They have Modern Folk Embroidery. They have Jan from Jan Hicks Creates, Cherry Hill Stitchery. They have a bunch and they're constantly adding new designers. So that's been really fun to see new designers added there. So that was a brief overview of the two different apps. If you have any other questions, just leave them below. I feel like I kind of have a good grasp on these apps. So if you ask me a question, I hopefully can answer it. That all being said, I started working on this one again, the Twisted Rainbow Sampler, and I am loving it. Warning, this is absolutely ginormous. So I'm stitching this on a 28 count white cashew linen. So that makes it big at baseline, but then it's also just a giant pattern. I'm using all the called for DMC colors, which are beautiful. And so that's how far I am. So I finished however many number of bands this is. This is the full width of the piece, but it is very, 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 very long. That's all my fabric. I think the fabric is like 36 inches long or something. So I still have quite a ways to go, but I'm really loving this. And just the colors are really fun because they're really bright colors that I don't often use. And the motifs are really pretty. So I'm really enjoying it. I'm stitching on 28 count white cashew linen, like I said before, two strands over two. And it's really pretty. And I will say, so when I started stitching it on the Silk app, I went in and like highlighted all of my previous progress. And that is so satisfying to do because like, you know, you're just like, normally when I'm stitching, I'm highlighting like every five stitches or so, I'm marking it off on the app. But when I'm doing like chunks of progress I already have, it's like marking off like, you know, 200 stitches at a time. And it is so satisfying. It makes me feel like I'm a super fast stitcher, even though this represented like weeks of work beforehand. So anyway, that's my Twisted Rainbow Sampler. You can see it all if I go, okay. I'm really, really enjoying it. Vivian Powers has a lot of really fun Quaker designs, often using bright colors. And I have a whole bunch more on my wish list from her. And it's super fun that they're now available on the Silk app. I will say a warning about using the apps. Once you start using them, you don't want to stitch using anything else. So like for me to even think about stitching from paper now is like, that's not happening. And when I go to stitch on patterns that aren't available on Pattern Keeper, like my Patchwork Quaker and coming up, my Made to Create Style from Caterpillar Cross Stitch, I will like constantly, like I still use the pattern on my tablet, but I go to like highlight them and then I can't because it's not in that app. And it just, I don't like it as much. But the patterns are beautiful, so I persevere. But fair warning, you may no longer want to use paper patterns once you switch to using apps because it's awesome. Okay, what else did I work on? The other older whip that I pulled out was Southern Land by Owl Forest Embroidery. And this is a pattern that I started last year. And I think around the same time, Lori from Mischievous Stitches also started it. She has since finished it and I have not. The first thing that's important to show you about this though is that on this pattern, I have my adorable needle minder. So this is my gazpacho needle minder from Rocio of Kokohama Stitchery, and this is her dog, Gazpacho, who's a cute little French bulldog? Yes, I think so. Anyway, she sent me this and it's so cute and I love it. So that's on this project. And here is my progress on it. So this is also one that I discovered works in Pattern Keeper, so that was very exciting and fun to highlight off all my progress. I'm using the DMC. So this pattern calls for Owl Forest Embroidery threads, their own hand-dyed threads, but they also provided a DMC conversion, and I'm doing the DMC conversion, which is beautiful, but I also will admit that the hand-dyed threads are gorgeous, and yeah, I would highly recommend if you have the financial means to get them, do it. But the DMC is beautiful too. I really enjoy stitching this. I called it a butterfly, but someone else mentioned it looked like a dragonfly on my Instagram, and you are probably absolutely right. So dragonfly, butterfly, whatever it is. Anyway, this is a really pretty pattern that I love, and I will never not comment on the fact that these little motifs here, here, and here to me look like jellyfish. I think they're supposed to be flowers. But they are jellyfish to me. So this is the jellyfish sampler. Okay, so that is my older whips that I worked on. I also worked on a couple of more recent whips. So one of them was a start I had just a couple, probably a month or so ago, that I started it and then I put it away. Because that's what happens, squirrel, get distracted, you know. So this is Cirque de Triangles by Ink Circles Designs. And it is a companion piece to my Cirque de Course or Circus of Hearts, which is behind me. So here is my start on that. So just a teensy start so far, but it's beautiful. This chart works in Pattern Keeper. And I'm stitching this on 32 count white Murano even weave. It's by Zweigart. I don't really know the difference between Murano or Lugana. It feels very similar to me, but anyway. It's a nice fabric. And this is a silk floss that I'm using, and it is Silks for You. And the color is number PR168. And I'm using two strands of silk over two. And it's really pretty, and I am really liking it. And I feel like it will coordinate very nicely with my Cirque de Course. So, yay. I'm really enjoying stitching on that one. Super, super fun. Okay, the other one I've been working on is one I'm getting very close to a finish on, and that is Everything in White by Durfine Fadden. I hope I'm saying that right. It is German, so I'm probably not. And this is available on the Silk Stitching app, so it's a pattern I purchased directly from there. And as you can see from the picture I just put up, it was designed to kind of be stitched in a light floss on light fabric. But I really wanted to kind of make it pop a bit more. So I'm stitching mine on this gorgeous piece of purple fabric from Fabric Flare called Pansy Purple. It's a 32 count even weave, and I am using DMC Ecru. And I just think it looks fantastic, and I love it, and it is so fun to stitch. And someone on Instagram commented that the sampler was made for me because it has a giant S in the middle, which is my first initial, and yes, totally agree, that is amazing. Over here is a spot where my hoop kind of rubbed off some of the fabric color, but I'm not too worried about it because it'll be covered by stitching. But yes, I love this. It's so pretty, and I'm really, really, really enjoying the combination of ecru and purple. I'm stitching this two strands of floss over two threads. So that is my Everything in White. And I think I'm like 63% done according to the Silk app. So getting pretty close to a finish. Loving this one. Love, love, love it. Okay, two more stitching projects to show you. I told you I worked on a lot the past couple weeks because I was going through my, you know how you sometimes just like go through your WIP pile because you're looking for something? Well, I went through my WIP pile and then I was like, oh, I want to work on this. I want to work on this. I want to work on this. So yeah, sometimes it's good to go through and look through things because you just like fall in love with your projects all over again. Okay, this next one, I can't remember if I had started this on my last video or not. Let's say I didn't, that's a new start. If not, whatever. So this is the Quaker's Pride pattern by Heestreak Steek Mooster, and it's available on the Silk Stitching app. And I'm stitching this along with Stacy of 911 Stitcher. You find her on Instagram or YouTube. She has a FlossTube channel. And we are stitching this together as a stitch along using the hashtag QuakersPrideSAL. It's been really fun to see everyone's progress on this, and there's some gorgeous projects out there. So here is mine. And I am stitching this on a 36 count hazy gray by Fabric Flare, which they very kindly sent to me. And this fabric is gorgeous. It's this beautiful mottled gray. I love it. I am stitching this with the called for DMC, except I did change. So this pattern calls for DMC Blanc, but I switched in DMC 3865 just because it's a little bit more like of a creamy white, and I want it, and it, I just felt like it showed up better on my fabric. So I'm really happy with how that's showing up. And look at this cute little bird. So I'm really enjoying stitching this. This is a massive project. So here's my fabric for it. You know, this will be a long-term one. I think it's like 325 stitches by 325 stitches, right? So it's huge, but I will get there eventually. And it's been really fun to stitch, and I love these colors together. So that is Quaker's Pride. Love to have you join. This is probably gonna take me several years to stitch, so join at any time. It is a very open-ended stitch along. Okay, speaking of stitch alongs, the last project I have to show you is my Made to Create stitch along, and this is designed by Caterpillar Cross Stitch, and this is a mystery stitch along. So a new part is released every month on the 25th, and I think we're at 4 parts released now, so there's 2 left to go, 6 parts in total, and each month is releasing a different letter. It's going to spell out create, which now has been spoiled because we have C-R-E-A, so we kind of know what's coming next, but it's been really fun to work on, and I am a little bit behind. I'm almost finished part 3, so I'm a little bit behind, but I'm really, really enjoying it. So this is going to be an R. It's just a P so far, but we have a skein of floss, a hoop, a quilt block, and then this is going to be a paintbrush, so I have to do is just stitch that there. And here's the cute little needle minder that came with it that says Made to Create. So yeah, there it is so far. I'm stitching this with the called for DMC on 32 count light mocha linen by Swigert, and this kit was very kindly provided to me by Sally from Caterpillar Cross Stitch. So I am loving this. One day I will live in a home where I have a craft room, and this will be framed in my craft room because it is very inspiring to look at and just think of all the different things I could make and create. So yeah, I'm loving this. You can still join in on this stitch along. It's available as a PDF on Caterpillar Cross Stitch's website. So you can either, if you want, you can wait until the very end and until all the parts have been released to see if it's something you really want to work on and stitch, or you can join in and the last 2 parts will be mystery. So that is that. All right, so that is all my stitching. I want to talk to you now about a giveaway I have. So let's talk about that. In the theme of Caterpillar Cross Stitch Mystery Stitch Alongs, the next one that is coming out is Hello Sunshine. And, you know, very mysterious, the promo picture here. To me, I'm like 100% certain this is the flamingo, and I think it's going to be so, so cute. So this is available now on Caterpillar Cross Stitch's website. So Sally, again, really kindly sent me the kit for this, which comes with all the gorgeous colors, 28 count even weave, and this adorable little toucan needle minder. How cute is he? I love it. So I'm really excited to stitch this. I had so much fun stitching the last tree that she did as a mystery stitch along, Hello Dear. And so I think Hello Sunshine is going to be so much fun to stitch. So what I'd like to do is I'm keeping this kit to stitch for myself, but I would like to give away a copy of the pattern. So Sally has the pattern available as PDF download. You can purchase it yourself on her website, but I'd like to give away a copy of one of the PDF downloads, which I will contact Sally to arrange to be sent to you. So this pattern, I believe it starts in June. I'm going to put that on the screen when it starts. And so the first part will be released that date, and then it'll come out monthly after that. So it's going to be really fun. It's always so fun to see everyone's progress. And even if you fall behind, no worries, you can catch up. I think last year for Hello Dear, I stayed caught up until like the last part, and then I fell way behind, but I got it done eventually. So it's really fun to stitch along together, and it's going to be a super cute piece. And I think the colors are going to just be so perfect for summer. So if you would like to win a PDF download of this pattern, you won't get the pattern quite yet because it doesn't release yet, but as soon as it releases, you'll get it. If you want to win that, just leave me a comment and include the word sunshine, and I will draw a winner for that in my next video. So super excited to start this. Hopefully I can finish my Made to Create before I start that one, but no guarantees. Okay, so that's all my stitching to talk about. Let's move on to knitting. A very busy sock knitter over the past couple weeks, and I have finished two pairs of socks, which is very exciting. One thing I have learned is that I can knit stockinette socks without looking. So if I'm just knitting on the leg or the foot, I can knit and I don't have to look, and it's all good. So every Wednesday, I have what's called our academic day. So for those who don't know, I'm a psychiatry resident. So I'm a physician who's now doing my subspecialty training to become a psychiatrist. I work in a clinic throughout the week, but on Wednesdays we have our academic day. And because of COVID, it's now on Zoom. So I have lectures all day on Wednesdays, which I have discovered I can knit during lecture. So if I'm working on a plain stockinette section of my sock, I can very easily knit while watching the lecture screen and listening. And I actually find that it helps me pay attention because I have something to do with my hands. If I don't, I get so distracted, and it's so hard to focus. I don't know if anyone else feels that way, but I found it's been really helpful to have something to work on while I'm listening to something, because I just pay so much better attention. And I actually look at the screen. So with that being said, that's meant that I've been able to finish some socks lately. So here's the first pair. I have these really nice sock blockers from Little Red Mitten, which I'll link below, and I'm really liking them. I don't actually like block my socks on these, but I just put them on because it makes for nice pictures. So here's my finished pair of socks. So this yarn is from Area 51 Fibers, and the colorway is called Let's Go to the Mall, which I think this just screams Let's Go to the Mall, right? As you can see, these are sisters, not twins. the stripes don't fully match. That's because I use a 50 gram skein instead of 100 gram skein. And so I just use up the whole skein. And so I don't worry about starting each pair of sock or each sock at the same spot. So also you can see this is where my end of round is, but it doesn't bother me. For the heels, toes, and cuffs, I used a mini skein from Crux Fibers, who is a yarn dyer out of the Yukon Territories. And this was part of a mini skein collection she had, which I think was called Tropical or Toucan or something like that. I don't think it's still available, but it matched really nicely with this. So these are my socks. I think I've said before that I've found for a 50 gram skein that has that is self-striping yarn, I do 15 stripes for the foot and 11 stripes for the leg. And that gives me, I can use pretty much the entire skein, and it gives me a sock that fits great. I do 64 stitches. I do 1x1 ribbing for the cuff, 64 stitches, and just plain stockinette for the leg. I do a slip stitch heel flap, and I do a garter border. So I do the first three stitches and the last three stitches in knit on both sides, but then my heel itself is knit one, slip one on the right side and purl across on the wrong side. Just makes it a little bit easier to pick up the gusset stitches, and I really like the way it looks. Then I do my gusset decreases, which is this line here. And then the toe, I just do a regular rounded toe, and then I Kitchener stitch the ends closed. So yeah, that is my pair of socks for me. So I'm very happy with how these turned out. They're so cute and colorful, and I just love a speckled yarn. So that was super fun to knit. All right, so this next pair of socks is the first pair I've ever knit for someone that is not me. I have realized that my sock drawer is quickly getting full, and I love knitting socks. I love knitting socks, and I don't want to stop anytime soon, so I need to start making them for other people. The first one up on my list is my boyfriend's stepmom because she always comments on my knit socks whenever I go over. She always wants to look at them. She's super interested in my projects and she's a very crafty person herself. So I decided she was extremely knitworthy and she gets my first pair of hand knit socks for someone other than me. So here they are. They're a little bit big on my sock blockers because my sock blockers are for my shoe size and she's a little bit bigger shoe size, but they still fit fairly well. So how fun are these? This yarn is gorgeous. It is from Brian Dye Works. Charity is probably, if not my favorite, one of my favorite yarn dyers. And this yarn is called Pickle Number 62. So Charity, what she does when she has leftover dye, she puts it, kind of mixes it all together and makes one-off skeins and she calls them pickles, which I think is super fun. So this yarn is just so pretty. The turquoise and dark green and blue, it's all so beautiful. So again, I did a 1x1 rib for the cuff. I knit, I want to say 70 rounds for the leg, just to make them a little bit longer leg. I again did the slip stitch heel flap with the garter edges. Decrease the gusset, and I think I did 65 rounds for the foot. I can't remember exactly. I think it was 65 though. And then again, I did just a rounded toe with a Kitchener stitch. So these are complete. So just for reference, so I wear a shoe size 6.5, and my boyfriend's stepmom is a shoe size of 8.5. So what I did, she has the same leg circumference as me. So I did 64 stitches for the leg and foot, but I just made them longer. She wanted a longer leg as well, so I made that longer, but I just made the foot longer. And basically I just measured her foot and then compared that to the measurement of my foot. And I know how many rounds I do for my foot. And so I just divided that, the number of rounds I do for my foot divided by how long my foot is. And then I just multiplied that by how long her foot is so I knew how many rounds to do. I hope that made sense. Basically, if you want to make socks that fit people, you got to measure their feet. So I did show up for dinner at my boyfriend's dad and stepmom's house with my measuring tape and said, let me measure your feet. But you know, people want me to make them socks. I got to measure their feet. So those are these socks and I'm so happy with how these turned out. The really fun thing is too, is that this was 100 gram skein of yarn and I used 71 grams. So what I did is I just measured my skein of yarn after I finished knitting on just a little kitchen scale. It was 39 grams. That means I used 61 grams. Oh my goodness, math. I used 61 grams of yarn to knit these socks. So I have 39 grams left, which I think I can probably get a pair of shorty socks out of. So I think I'm going to try that. But here's my socks, second pair of socks. Very happy with these. So yay. I will just quickly show you my sock blockers too. So I got these from the Little Red Mitten. And these are really great for taking pictures of your socks. I think some people do block their socks. So like they'll wash them and then they'll dry them on these. I have like 15 pairs of hand knit socks and one set of sock blockers. So that is not happening, but they make them look really nice for pictures and for videos. So I got these from Leo and Roxy. I think they were like $16. Sorry, not from Leo and Roxy, from their yarn store, Little Red Mitten. These are about $16. And I got the size medium, which is good for a women's US shoe size 5.5 to 7.5. I'll link those below. But yeah, I really, really like them. Okay, last knit project I have to show you is the shawl I had started last video. So I've gotten quite a bit done on that. I think you can sense a theme. Last video I had started all the knitting things and this video I worked on all the stitching things, which I just tend to alternate back and forth. So this shawl is the Temperance Shawl by Malabrigo. And this is a shawl that calls for 3 skeins of fingering weight yarn. So I did a bit of stash diving and I came up with 3 beautiful skeins. So I'll show you those first. The first one is this lovely red, which is by Smash Knits, who is a yarn dyer out of Winnipeg, Manitoba. And this colorway is called Crunching Leaves. And this is just like the perfect fall color. It's just so beautiful. Also, this is my little yarn cake now that I've used up most of it. So that's Crunching Leaves. And this is I believe it's either a 75-25 merino nylon or it's an 80-20 merino nylon, something like that. So that's the first color. The next color is by Brian Dye Works because, you know, Charity is like my favorite dyer. And this color is called Nori, which is seaweed, with Japanese for seaweed. So this is called Nori and it's this gorgeous, like variegated tonal green. So beautiful. And this is her 75-25 base. So 75% superwash merino, 25% nylon. It's very soft and lovely. And the last color I'm using, this ball is falling apart. This is by Camp Fiber Yarns. And this is her 80-20 base, so 80% superwash merino, 20% nylon. And it is from her Color of the Month Club. So she's doing a Mythology Color of the Month Club. I've just been buying individual colors that I've liked. And this, I think, was from March, and it's called Eros and Psyche, which I forget exactly what the mythology is behind that, but I love the color. So the Crunching Leaves and Nori are both still available on those dyers' websites. I don't think this one is still available, but it's beautiful. It's a lovely, like, browny, speckly color, and I think it just goes so nicely with the other colors. Okay, so let's show you my shawl. And I am kind of getting close to the end. So the way that the shawl is constructed is you start off with doing some garter stripes, and you're gradually increasing on both sides. Then you do a slip stitch section and change colors, and then you're alternating between a garter stripe and a stockinette stripe. And then you go into a section of twisted ribbing, which looks amazing, but takes forever to do. So I had put this away at this section because it was taking me so long. But then I read through the pattern and realized this was the only section of twisted rib in the design. So I'm like, if I can get through this, I can fly. So I finished that. And then there's a section of stockinette stripes, then a section of garter with eyelets, and then it goes into just all garter stripes. So that's the part I'm at now. And I'm going to try to show this to you. It's a little bit hard to visualize how it's going to look because it's on the needles. But basically, let's see here. So there's one end. It comes down to a point, and then we go all the way across to this end. So when I wear it, it'll be like this, with these ends tied around, and there'll be a point at the bottom. So I really like the construction of this because oftentimes with shawls, you're starting with a small number of stitches. So like starting here and then increasing, increasing, increasing. And then when you go to bind off, you have like 500 stitches, which is beautiful, but takes forever to bind off. So what I really like about this is you're basically increasing on a diagonal. I can show this to you. So the center line of the shawl is slowly kind of, how do I describe this? Basically, once you're past this section, you start only increasing on this side and you're decreasing on this side. So it's kind of coming into a point this way. So the total number of stitches is staying constant at 200 stitches, but you're getting this like elongated shape because you're only increasing on one side. It's kind of hard to explain, but basically I'm only knitting 200 stitches per row, which goes much quicker. And I'm really liking how these colors are all playing with each other. It's really pretty. So that is my temperance shawl. It's coming along nicely. I should have it finished by my next video. And once it's blocked, it's gonna look fabulous. It's kind of, I don't know, it's not quite watermelon, but it kind of looks like watermelon to me, especially this section with the holes, with the eyelets. So the other thing I wanted to mention about this too is that there are a lot of color changes in this shawl. You're only ever working with one color per row. But oftentimes when you're knitting a shawl or anything that has lots of color changes, you have a million ends to weave in the end. I don't do that because I weave in my ends as they go. I learned how to do that last year and now I always do that. So you can see right here I have an end and it is woven in, and I have another end here and it's woven in. So the way I do it is I use the Weaving Steven method, which I'll link below, and that's a method from Steven West of how to weave in your ends as you go. Honestly, I know this sounds like a bit of hyperbole, but honestly, it is life-changing. The fact that you do not have to weave in ends at the end of your project is just so amazing. So I'd highly recommend that tutorial, and that's what I do. I don't trim my ends until, so once I've done my project, I block it, and I don't trim my ends until after I've blocked the project, just because when you block it, things can stretch out a little bit, so I'll trim it after it's blocked. But basically, instead of needing to weave in a million ends when I'm done, I just need to trim them, which is much less annoying to do than weaving in a million ends. So highly recommend checking out that tutorial if you're still someone that does not weave in your ends as you go. What are you waiting for? It is just the best. So that is that. The last thing I have to show you today, going on our Brian Dyeworks theme, is a stash acquisition I got in the mail this past week, and that is the yarn to knit the Scout Shawl by Florence Sperling. So you know me, I love knitting shawls, and when I saw this pattern, I think I literally gasped out loud because it's just so beautiful. And I was kind of thinking what yarn I wanted to knit it in, and then Charity had mentioned on her Instagram that she could put together kits for it, and I was like, oh my goodness, how can I resist this? Of course I can't. So we had kind of messaged back and forth and picking up the colors, and I am just so happy with it. So I'm going to show them to you. I'll show you all the colors first, and then I'll show you them individually. So here are my colors, and isn't it amazing? I'm super excited for this. So let's go through them. So I'll also put a link below. She has the kits available on her website in case you're interested. The first thing to note is that this is a non-superwash yarn. So I've kind of started to get, I feel like it's just a trend now. It's a good trend in the yarn world that everyone's like moving towards non-superwash yarns. And for those of you who don't know the difference, a lot of the yarn I use is superwash yarn, which means it can go in the washing machine without any problems, which is fantastic for things like socks because I'm not hand washing those. I put them in the washing machine and I hang them to dry. But that means the yarn is pretty highly processed in order to make it superwash. So non-superwash is kind of more natural, rustic. It's not as soft. It's more rustic is the word. This is not scratchy at all. Like I will put this on my face and it is not scratchy. I probably shouldn't do that. I'm gonna get makeup on this. It's not scratchy or anything, but it's definitely not the same softness that a superwash yarn is. But it's kind of like more natural. It's like closer to the sheep. And it's just, I don't know, there's something about like the toothiness of it that is very satisfying to knit with. It just feels like more substantial. I don't know, it's really hard to explain. You just gotta, when you become an obsessed knitter, these things matter to you. Anyway, that being said, so this is the first time I've gotten her, non-superwash base, which is a 4-ply Highland yarn. And it's fingering weight yarn. It's gorgeous. So this is the bare colorway. So it's the undyed yarn. And this is kind of the main color of the shawl. The other colors it comes with. So this is 100 gram skein. You also need 100 gram skein of one of the other colors. So this pink, and this is called Cherry Ice Cream. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Also so nice. She labeled each color as to which color it is in the pattern. So like C is color one, color two, color three. So I don't have to try to remember, which is really nice. So Cherry Ice Cream. So pretty. And then the other three colors you just needed 50 gram skeins of. So this one here is Thyme. It's so beautiful. It's kind of similar to Nori. But it's a little bit more like foresty green instead of hunter green. Beautiful. The next one is called Basil or Basil. How do you say it? Basil or Basil? I say Basil. So that is Basil. And this is just, oh my goodness, how pretty is this? It's got a couple speckles in it. And the last one is Plum Jam. How pretty is that? So those three are all 50 gram skeins. So I am so excited to cast this on. I'm gonna try to finish a shawl or two first before I start this one, because I know as soon as I start this one, it is all I'm gonna want to knit on. It's colorwork, it's gorgeous, it's fabulous. And again, it's kind of knit in sections, so you never have like a million colors on, sorry, not a million, a million stitches on at the same time, which I really like. So I'm very excited to start that, if you couldn't tell. Okay, well, I think that's all I have for you today. I'm noticing I'm starting to talk very quickly, so I'm starting to get, you know, overly giddy. And before this video dissolves into me having fits of giggles, let's just call it there. I hope you're all doing well during this time. I know I say this every week, but, you know, it's really stressful, and lockdowns are awful, and I hate them. I understand why we need them and all of that, but it still doesn't negate the fact that they're pretty awful. So I hope you're all doing well, and I hope that watching this video today has made you kind of be able to escape from the real world for a little bit, and you can enjoy some crafting time as well. One other thing I wanted to mention was I did have a couple people on my last video ask if I had a buy me a coffee link, which I did not, but I now do. So that is linked below. And what buy me a coffee is a way that people can send, I guess, donations to a channel. So if you're someone that wanted to kind of support the channel financially, this is a great way to do it. Again, zero pressure to do that. I didn't even know that this was a thing until someone mentioned it. Because they're like, I want to buy you a coffee, get a link. I was like, okay, so I did. But that's just below. So some people have mentioned they wanted to send me money to help cover postage for giveaways and such. So if you want to do that, that link's below. If you don't want to do it, I don't care. We can still be friends. So that's that down there. The other thing is if you want to subscribe, that would be amazing. It's super fun to see this little community grow. So yeah, other thing, don't forget, if you want to enter the giveaway for the Hello Sunshine pattern only, leave me a comment below with the word sunshine. And if you want to buy the full kit from Caterpillar Cross Stitch's website, you can use the coupon code SHILOH10 for 10% off the full kit. So that just applies to the full kit, not the individual pattern, needle wand, or anything like that. So that's kind of a nice deal in case you wanted to get the full kit. Okay, that's really all I have to say for this time. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, happy stitching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.